Paris, New York, and now Cincinnati. You bet, say image gurus who gave News 5's John London a sneak peek at their strategy for marketing the Queen City. That's new at 5:30.
Well, come Friday morning here inside the Aronoff Center, all kinds of creative notions will be bouncing off these walls. With the World Choir Games just 2 months away, maximizing the story of Cincinnati's progress takes center stage. Top-tier status has eluded Cincinnati with its symbolic, iconic fountain in modern times. But marketing mavens around here perceive a timely window to up the ante on image.
Really, some really good things that have happened in Cincinnati over the past several years. And with the World Choir Games coming in just 64 short days, I think this is Cincinnati's opportunity to really solidify and find our place in the national media dialogue.
So, some top travel and tourism writers from USA Today, Cleveland Plain Dealer, Long Weekends Magazine, and other media outlets will be in town Friday to interact with local business, museum, and community leaders.
3, 2, 1.
About getting the most out of what's going on, like the remake of Washington Park and the new riverfront that is part Renaissance, part still taking shape.
Getting that word out is so important because I think we all know it here to a point. But I think people outside of Cincinnati, especially those cities that are around us, places like Lexington and Louisville and Columbus and Pittsburgh, people outside of Cincinnati need to hear more and more about.
The resurgence of Vine Street through Over the Rhine is one example. The construction of a casino is another. Organizers expect the World Choir Games to focus, internationalize on this city, and upgrade its tourism status to destination class. At least, that's the goal.
The way for all of us to really make that happen is to work together.
So there you go, Cincinnati as comeback city. Since 2005, it has hosted 12 of the nation's top 25 African-American and multicultural conventions. At the Aronoff Center, John London, News 5.